Hello guys, good evening. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, no problem. We'll start the class. Today we'll discuss on physiological disorders in floriculture crops. Firstly, we'll discuss what you mean by physiological disorder. What exactly the physiological disorder means? Yes, anyone?
Physiological disorder means that it's due to excess of or deficiency of some nutrients or maybe some environmental conditions.
Yes, this is mainly due to the physical growing or the environmental factors, not due to the any other nutrients. Disorders may be due to nutrients also. Mainly due to the physical elements which will occurs during the growth of that plant. Hence the term physiological disorders. It's not the disease, it's the disorders, not due to any pest or diseases. Then only we will call the disorder. Okay, then we'll discuss one by one. Coming to rows, in the rows we'll have the mainly the blind shoots. Blind shoot is the major problem in rows. What is the symptom? Here, the abortion of the flowers, buds, are the flower buds not found at the end of the shoots. Means these shoots are the branches are not able to produce the quality flowers. That's why they are called blind shoots. They won't produce the buds. If it is produced also, they will going to abort. Means they will be, they are not going to bloom into a quality flower. Okay, then what are the main causes for the blind shoots? Mainly the low photosynthetic accumulation. The photosynthesis will be very less. Why? Due to the low temperature, the photosynthesis won't occur that much quantity to produce the more photosynthesis in order to produce the flowers. Low temperature and the low photosynthetic accumulation rate. Then how can we control this blind shoot? Mainly in protected cultivation, we can go for the CO2 enrichment up to 1000 ppm. This is the optimum. So what will happen if we going to increase the CO2 concentration in protected cultivation?
What, sir?
What will going to happen if we enrich the CO2, carbon dioxide, in the protected cultivation or in the polyhouse?
Then photosynthetic rate will be increased, sir.
Yes, if the CO2 concentration in the polyhouse is directly proportional to the activity of photosynthesis. Okay, that too we need to give very optimum. 1000 ppm is the optimum concentration. So up to this level, the photosynthetic activity will be optimum and maximized. If we give more than 1000, maybe 1500, 2000, what will happen for the plant? Plant won't respond. The CO2 will cause some injuries in the plant, some abnormalities, right? Yes or no?
Sir, repeat again, sir.
What will happen if the concentration is more than 1000 or 2000? It will going to cause carbon dioxide injury for the plant. it will going to suffocate. The photosynthetic rate will be drastically reduced. Why? Because CO2 is not in the optimum concentration in the polyps. It will going to injure the plant. Then one more measure to control is the foliar spray of abscisic acid, ascorbic acid, not abscisic, it is ascorbic acid at 1000 ppm or bending technique. Got this? Why we follow the bending technique? Bending is the important physiological horticultural practice followed in the rows in order to utilize the blind shoot or the weak shoots to convert the photosynthesis into the very healthy shoots.
So how ascorbic acid help here, sir?
The foliar spray of ascorbic acid, how it will going to help? Any logical
vitamin
reason?
C. Vitamin C.
Yeah. How it will directly affect the or it will control the blind shoot production in rows? Is there any logical reason how exactly it will going to control?
Sir, fruit is called, sir, hips, which is resource of vitamin C.
Yeah. This abscisic acid will give the some resistance or tolerance for the low temperature. Okay. It won't feel sick if the rose cultivated in a polyhouse, if that polyhouse temperature goes below 15 degree, the plant becomes sick. So this will be overtake or controlled or resistant with the abscisic acid spray. The plant won't feel the low temperature. If it won't feel the low temperature, if the plant, this will, the straight answer will be.
So voice is breaking, sir. Repeat once.
Okay. Now clear?
Yes, sir. Okay.
This ascorbic acid will give the resistance or tolerance towards the low temperature. What will happen in turn? If it is low temperature in the polyhouse also, it will be optimum. It will perform the optimum photosynthetic accumulation in the plant. Then it will in turn doesn't yield the blind shoot. It will only give rise to healthy shoots. Getting the point?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it will give some resistance or tolerance towards the low temperature. Then another important disorder in rose is bent neck. Why? What is the symptom? Bending of stems at the neck region after harvesting or during the post-harvest handling. Why? What is the main cause? This is mainly due to premature bud harvest, mainly due to exposure to high temperature or low humidity, lower relative humidity, or due to improper accumulation of CO2, or due to low photosynthetic rates, or maybe ethylene, or due to excessive water loss during the handling. Bent shoot will occur during the harvesting also and after the harvesting also. Post harvest handling also sometimes causes the blind shoots. Before harvest, mainly due to low temperature or high temperature or maybe lower humidity, or due to premature bud harvest. After the harvest, what will be the main reason? Mainly due to excessive moisture loss during the handling. At that time only the shoots will be bent, the cut flower going to bend. How it can be managed? Mainly by using 2000 ppm cobalt nitrate or 10% of sucrose as a floral preservative, or maybe use of fumigation with a methyl bromide technique. Okay, this is important fumigant used in the rose, methyl bromide. They won't ask in depth regarding the symptoms or the causes. Mainly they will ask which are all the physiological disorders associated with which crop and maybe some of the main causes. Got it? Then bullhead.
Yes, sir. Sir, function of cobalt nitrate, what sir? What is the function? Cobalt nitrate here.
Use of 2000 ppm cobalt nitrate. This is a floral preservative after the harvesting.
Okay.
Yeah. Then one more important is bullhead. Here the central petal of the bud remains unopened. Only the partly developed and bud will appears flat. The bud will won't unfurl or it won't completely open and it will be flat in appearance. That's why this is called bullhead. Mainly due to it is possible that there is a lack of carbohydrates to the developing petals, or maybe the cause of bullheading is yet not known. Okay, yet to know regarding the cause of bullhead. Then however the thrips infestation will also cause the some malformation in the flowers, and also the lower temperature and sometimes the varieties also correlated with the bullhead formation, mainly due to lack of carbohydrates in developing petals and maybe due to thrips infestation, or sometimes maybe some varieties will be genetically leads to bullhead. How this can be overcome? By planting the resistant varieties or by lowering the relative humidity. Yet the reason for the cause of bullhead is unknown. Okay, then in carnation, mainly the calyx splitting. Calyx splitting means the flower bud opens and the petal reaches their full size, and the calyx may split down either to half or completely. The calyx will completely split down. Okay, this is mainly due to the low temperature, low nitrogen, low boron or closer planting. The main reason will be the boron deficiency associated with low nitrogen. Low nitrogen, low boron and the low temperature mainly. How it can be rectified? By maintaining the uniform night temperature, or due to, or by banding technique. Have you heard of banding in carnation? This is also one of the important horticulture operation. Yes?
No, sir.
Banding, calyx band. There will be like cellophane band. Have you seen the cellophane bands on the apple while you were in the market?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, like that. The banding will come for the carnation. What do you call for that? Bud caps in carnation. This also helps the to tackle the calyx splitting, and sometimes the rubber bands also used. Then slab side. This is also one of the important physiological disorder in the carnation. This is also very frequently asked question. Slab side. Here the bud will don't open evenly, so that the petals protrude one side only. Means if the bud is like this, the flowers will won't open completely. Only one side of the petals will be opened and other side will be like only one side of the petals is completely opened and other side will be in flat condition. This will cause the slab side, mainly due to the cooler environment, climatic factors. How it can be rectified? Gradual increase or maintain the optimum temperature in the greenhouse. Then sleepiness. This is also one of the important physiological disorder. Here the upward curling or cupping or bending of petals is seen in the carnation, mainly due to why sleepiness is caused in carnation?
Ethylene.
Mainly due to ethylene injury. Carnation sleepiness is due to ethylene injury, and is also associated with the calcium deficiency, high temperature during the storage. In the storage also, this will cause due to high temperature. Then how to rectify this? Store the store the carnation free from the ethylene producing products. Okay, while you go for the storage, try to avoid the products which are in the same room which produce high ethylene. Can you name the examples for the high ethylene producing products or the produce fruits, vegetables, flowers? Which
broccoli?
Okay, broccoli. Then give the example for high ethylene synthesis fruits. Mainly apple, then guava, then give some examples for high ethylene producing fruits.
Custard, papaya, custard apple.
Yes. Papaya, custard apple.
Support apples.
Yes.
Mango also there.
Mainly, we have to concentrate on which are all the important fruits which will produce highest concentration of ethylene. Means those are all very highly prone for the post-harvest loss. You need to remember high ethylene producing fruits and vegetables. Okay. Then in carnation, mainly epinasty. What do you mean by epinasty? Epinasty means continuous growth of leaves will be there here, followed by yellowing, mainly due to the higher concentration of ethylene in the storage room or in the greenhouse during the cultivation. Then how it can be controlled? Mainly by storing in a light condition at the higher temperature or by spraying the axin. Right, you remember epinasty is the important physiological disorder in chrysanthemum. Then apart from the epinasty, we have crooked neck. Then bronzed foliage. Then bleaching of petals. Then quilling of petals. Then crown buds. Then bract buds. These are also the important physiological disorders in chrysanthemum. Apart from the epinasty, crooked neck is also an important one. You remember that one. Then in gladiolus, mainly the tip burning or the fluoride injury, mainly due to why did you cause tip burning?
Fluoride injury, right?
Yes, mainly due to fluoride. Then geotropic bending of spikes in gladiolus, why it is caused? Downward movement of auxins or IAA. Okay, then how can we rectify this geotropic bending? Mainly by keeping the spikes or the inflorescence vertically during the storage or during the transportation. Yes or no? Geotropic bending is mainly due to the downward movement of auxin or IAA. This is very important. Then in anthurium, the flower abortion, the flower deformation, and the rosette formation. Then sticking, jamming, these are all the important disorders in anthurium. This sticking and jamming is mainly the variety dependent characters. And also sometimes if the temperature is low or the relative humidity is If the relative humidity is also high, this will cause the sticking and jamming in anthurium. Then in tulip, mainly this topple or the water neck is the important one in tulip. You will find in the mind the following: tulip is correlated with topple or chalking. This topple is mainly due to deficiency of calcium. Okay. Then apart from the chalking, iron, okay, then cuivre, then nose rot, these are also the disorder in tulip. They rarely ask in the tulip, but in lilium they will definitely ask the bud blast abortion. Bud blast is a physiological disorder is associated with the lilium due to withering or due to high temperature or the low light intensity. The bud will won't open completely. Then this leaf scorch, leaf burn or the tip burn, this is also mainly due to
bleaching of flower bud means
bleaching. If the if you consider the flower color of lilium or the tulip is consider red or purple or pink, in the bleaching what will happen, the color intensity will be low, it will be lightish in the photo shoot, in the photo shoot, while we take the pictures opposite to sun, the photos will bleach, means the light intensity will be more there, the photos will be too lightish, that we call bleaching. You should know. Yes. Then this leaf scorch or the leaf burn or the tip burn is mainly due to high light intensity associated with calcium deficiency also. Then high fluoride in the water, soil, air. Okay. For any calcium deficiency, you will recommend the foliar application of 1% calcium chloride before the visibility of the buds. Or if you are growing the crop in the fluoride soils, then only you can recommend the foliar application of calcium chloride. Yes or no? Then greasiness, where you will find the physiological disorder greasiness?
Cauliflower.
Okay. In the carnation also you will find the greasiness is mainly due to genetic factor of the variety.
Slide is not changing.
Yes.
Slide is not changing, sir.
Okay. It is from my short notes. The greasiness is okay. The greasiness is mainly from mainly in carnation.
Carnation.
Yes. Then blackening of petals.
Rose.
Yes. Blackening of petals is mainly in rose. Then crooked neck.
Rose.
No, crooked neck. Now only we discussed now. Crooked neck is mainly in chrysanthemum.
Yes, sir.
Quilling of flowers.
What's
that? Quilling of flowers. Yes, in chrysanthemum only. Then in gerbera, we have stem break, right? Stem break. Negative geotropism.
Gladiola.
Yes, mainly due to uneven distribution of auxin. Yes. In gerbera, drooping or stem break is the important physiological disorders. Then in anthurium, mainly jamming, sticking, then flower of the abortion. Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Sir, please show the sir symptoms of anthurium, sir, like sticking, jamming.
Yes, I will show it. Wait. Physiological disorders. Anthurium. Yes, in this picture you can observe the ethylene injury. It's visible. This is visible.
Yes.
Yes. This is my incarnation. The ethylene injury. Yes. Here you see the lily bud abortion or the abscission. The bud will be aborted, means it won't develop further. Here also in tulip, the tulip blindness or the bud blast. Yes, black nose is the important physiological disorder in
what, sir?
Black nose. Have you heard of this black nose?
No, sir.
Black nose is a disease or disorder? Black nose is a disorder in anthurium. You see the endings are there, na? The two in chalking or jamming or sticking. This path, this path will be unable to open completely. The healthy one should be like this one. It should be completely open. But in here, if it in case of jamming, it will fail to open completely. That's we call jamming. Have you seen the calla lily? Which is this physiological disorder in tomato? Can you identify this physiological disorder?
Blossom and rot.
Yes, blossom and rot. This one?
Fruit cracking.
Yes. What is the main cause of fruit cracking in
calcium deficiency.
Calcium deficiency. Then?
Boron deficiency, sir.
Yes. Then mainly due to the fluctuation of soil moisture.
Moisture.
Yes. If the after a long dry spell, if the rain is came, means the fruit will crack easily. This one? What do you call if the fruit is cracking in the upperwards?
Radial cracking.
Yes. We have
radial
two,
cracking.
Yeah, we have two types of cracking, right? In the tomato.
Radial concentrics.
Yes. We have two types of cracking in tomato. One is radial and another one is concentric cracking. This is concentric or radial?
Radial means?
Radial means upside to downside. Concentric means the concentric circles. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This one, calyx splitting. Here, you see, this is the calyx na in carnation. This is the supporting structure where the petals can unfurl. But here, the calyx itself will going to crack. This may be due to the fluctuation of temperature also, maybe due to closer spacing also, mainly due to boron level. Then what else we need to discuss? Is someone is covering the medicinal plantation and medicinal crops?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No one is covering?
No, sir.
Okay. Then how you will manage that?
You have to study, sir.
You haven't approached the sir? You need the class, right? On plantation, medicinal. You need to approach them, then only they will give the class on medicinal art.
Yes, sir, like just like bullet points.
Yes, maybe some important. Definitely, you are going to get some, maybe due to some 5 to maximum up to 15 questions from plantation, medicinal, and aromatic. You can get. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That's why you need to read medicinal also. Very important one. Okay.
Yes, sir.
The recording